Welcome to the Changing Products Training Module of the FAS Catalog Platform, or FCP, Vendor Training Series.
In this module, we will discuss when and how to create a change products action and how to publish the change products action. When and how to create a change products action. The FCP change products catalog action requires that the vendor first link and open applicable EMOD modification prior to creating the change products action in FCP. Here, we see a validation message indicating we need to first create a modification in EMOD as there are currently no modifications that we can link. Note, manufacturer part number change is not supported. If the vendor needs to change the manufacturer part number for a product, then follow the steps to first delete the product from the catalog. Once the product is deleted, then follow the steps to add the product back to the catalog with its updated manufacturer part number. The vendor navigates to the contract in EMOD to create an applicable modification type. For the FCP change products action, the applicable modification types are economic price adjustments, EPA, with commercial price list increase, economic price adjustments, EPA, without commercial price list increase, permanent price reduction based on most favored customer, permanent price reduction industry partner requested, and product descriptive change. For the purposes of this video, we will create a product descriptive change modification. Once the modification is created, an EMOD ID generates. In this case, our modification ID ends in Y78, which we can now link to our FCP action. The vendor can either navigate directly back to FCP or press the Go to FCP button in the EMOD's Upload Documents section. Back on the Create New Catalog Action page, the vendor can now select the Change Products Action Radio button and select the EMOD ID in the drop-down menu. Here, we will select the product descriptive change modification we just created, ID ending in Y78. We will also select all of my products will be published for sale on GSA Advantage, which means we only need to upload a product file to our FCP action. For more information regarding the some or none options, please see the catalogs with mixed composition training module. Press the continue button to create the catalog action. How to publish the change products action. We see various sections listed in the main portion of the page that are specific to this action's workflow. Each section must be completed in succession. The first step of our workflow for this action is for the vendor to upload one or multiple product files, depending on the size of the catalog, for validation. All vendors should start this process by downloading the currently approved catalog files and opening the file in Microsoft Excel. The currently approved product file contains all products currently available on the catalog. For our change action, we will remove any products that do not need to be changed. If we were to include additional products in the product file, then this would cause delays in both market research generation and increase the time it takes for the CSCO to review the file. Vendors must include any addition or changes to existing photo file references on the product file. Once the change products action is published, any staged photos will publish alongside the new products if the update photo action has been completed. See the photos training module for more information regarding this process. After updating the product file, the vendor uploads one or multiple product files to the FCP catalog action. Submit the file through for automated data and business rule validation. The action status updates automatically as validation checks are performed. If a user role is not specified in the action status label, then this means no action is needed by the user and the system will automatically progress through its processing. If the product file fails data or business rule validation, then an error report will be generated for the vendor to review and take action on. See the product file and error remediation training module for more information regarding this process. The page can be refreshed to view the updated statuses. If the product files pass all validations, then the system will generate a compliance and pricing report with market research for the products listed. This process can take several hours, and once complete, the vendor receives an email notification indicating the action is ready for next steps. Once the market research process is complete and a compliance and pricing report generated, the action status updates to CMP report available, pending vendor upload, and it can now be downloaded for review.
For change product actions only, an additional tab displays in the product file with CMP labeled Products Change. This tab contains information that allows the CSCO to better compare the original product information in the last approved catalog file against the product changes made in the Change Product Action product file. Please note that the information in this tab is automatically added by the FCP application based on the data in the Products tab. Any direct edits made to this tab will be disregarded when the file is submitted to EMOD, and original values will be displayed for the CSCO. See the Compliance and Pricing Report training module for more information regarding this report and what is returned. Now, address any compliance and pricing flags.
Once the vendor is done modifying the compliance and pricing report, the vendor uploads the file or multiple files back to FCP for submission. After submitting the file, the system runs through the same validation checks as before and will return error reports to the user for remediation as needed. Once all product files pass validation, FCP automatically submits the product files to EMOD, as indicated by the Sending to EMOD action status. EMOD has a file size limit of 100 megabytes. If the file exceeds this size, the system will automatically split the file to be within the file limit. Do not return to EMOD immediately until an email notification is received that the file or files have been submitted to EMOD. Once the submission to EMOD is complete, our action status updates to requires vendor action. Vendor must submit to CSCO in EMOD. No further action is needed by the vendor in FCP at this time. Now, after navigating back to EMOD as our vendor and to our contract, the vendor will press the Edit Mod button to open this modification for review and submission. In the Upload Documents section, we now see the product file submitted by the vendor in FCP in the price proposal template row. If the product files exceeds the 100 megabyte limit explained earlier, then multiple files will display here. Vendors can now download and review the FCP file transmitted here. The vendor edits the modification as needed in EMOD, ultimately submitting the modification to the CSCO. Once the vendor submits the modification, we can navigate back to the action in FCP to see that the status is now pending CSCO review. I am now logged into FCP as our generic CSCO user account, and from our catalog overview page, I can see the list of actions currently under GSA review. Clicking into the Change Products action, this page shows the product file with the compliance and pricing report submitted by the vendor. along with the final workflow section for capturing CSCO determination. The CSCO can either intend to approve, which progresses the workflow along for the CSCO to then approve and sign in FSS Online. The approved products will then publish in GSA Advantage. Intend to request clarifications, which indicates the CSCO will allow vendor edits in FSS Online to send the action back to the vendor to make edits and resubmit for the CSCO to re-review, or intend to reject, which indicates the CSCO will reject the modification in FSS Online, which will then automatically update the FCP action status to rejected and end the workflow. In the case of rejection, the vendor would need to initiate a new product's action in FCP. Additionally, for any determination path, the CSCO can input a comment, which will be saved to the action and sent to the vendor. Comments will be helpful for clarifications so that the vendor can better understand the reasoning for the determination. For our training demonstration, I will select intend to approve for this action. Pressing the submit determination button, the action updates to read only, and the status now displays as requires CSCO action, complete mod in FSS Online. At this point, no further actions are needed in FCP, and I will switch over to the FSS Online desktop application where we will submit for final approval and signatures for this modification. In FSS Online, after the CSCO navigates to the modification, they can perform their review and process the modification through to the approval state. After the modification package is marked for approval, it is ready for vendor e-signature in EMOD. Navigating back to EMOD as our vendor in the signed modifications section, I will press the button to step through the DocuSign process. Once complete, this modification will be ready for CO e-signature back in FSS Online. Navigating back to FSS Online as our CO, I will act on behalf of the CO and complete the CO DocuSign process. Once the DocuSign process is complete in FSS Online, the modification is awarded. Navigating back to FCP as our vendor, I can now see the action status as pending publishing on Advantage. In the background, the system is submitting our change products action through to GSA Advantage for publishing. Generally, this should be an overnight process. It can take several days to complete, depending on the size of the catalog and also other catalogs that have been submitted to be published. Once the change products action is successfully published to Advantage, the vendor receives an email notification indicating the action is published. The FCP action status updates to published on Advantage. The currently approved catalog file automatically regenerates with the product information included in the approved change products action. Time for a knowledge check. To change items, you should submit a product file containing just the products that are changing or your entire catalog. Just the products that are changing, including additional items, will slow down processing time. True or false, vendors can use the change action to update manufacturer part numbers. False, MPNs cannot be changed via the change action. Vendors need to delete the product and then add it with the new manufacturer part number. This concludes the Changing Products Training Module. Thank you for watching.